What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Ari. Welcome back to AM Island Vibes. Hope you guys are doing good. I'm doing alright. Today we're back with another reaction video. Today we're gonna be reacting to Cocoa Butter. Jamaicans try each other's jerk chicken. I wonder if they're trying to try Jamaican jerk chicken. I wonder if that's what they're doing. Sounds interesting. But if you guys are new to the channel, man, smash that button, subscribe. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers, alright? Help your boy get there. But let's check this out, right? I realize what a lot of people around the world try to do is make jerk chicken. But y'all, jerk chicken don't even be half as good as the actual jerk chicken. Your jerk chicken don't even taste as good as an amateur jerk master. I don't even jerk master. Jerk master. But anyway, someone who made jerk chicken at least half. You know what I mean? Let me tell you the first thing y'all to start off wrong. Y'all don't wash your blasted meat. Y'all take it out of the package y'all buy from and rinse water over and say you wash your meat. No, salt, vinegar, and lime or lemon. Let the bit soak. You clean up your chicken. That's what y'all ain't know nothing about that, right? And that reminds me of cleaning, right? I saw, what do y'all name is? Queen Najee, right? She was doing an interview and she's like, I do something so different when I'm washing my dishes. I love to wash dishes. This is what I do. I add the dish liquid in the water and I put a little cap of bleach in it, you know. That's how I wash my dishes. Just give it a little scent. So I'm sitting there thinking, what's different? So it took a minute for me to click on. She's talking about adding bleach to the water. And I'm like, that isn't a normal thing in everybody's household. People, add bleach to your dirty dishwater. It kills back. You telling me y'all niggas out here just washing y'all pots and for utensils with just soap and water? Stop it. Put a little bit of bleach in that damn water. But let's get into the video. I ran on too much now.
That is okay. American. This is American food. This is not no Islanders food. This is
I ain't gonna lie though. We'll tell you your food tastes bad straight up in your face.
My name is Aja Dawson. I was born in LA, but I bring all that Caribbean energy and
you own Caribbean. You born in LA. What the hell is Caribbean in it? Listen, you own Caribbean. You own from the Caribbean. Caribbean, you're from the Caribbean. All right, that's exactly how I know you're from over here. Caribbean? No, we don't. But only people who outside the Caribbean say Caribbean. We don't say that. We say Caribbean.
I make really amazing Jamaican food.
So my name is Michael Silvera. I'm from the Bronx, in New Jersey, half and half.
And my name is Drebo. Born and raised in Los Angeles, California. Grew up here my whole life. Both my parents from Jamaica. We're on a Jamaican restaurant in mid-city LA, so here to see what this jerk chicken talking about. So I learned how to make jerk chicken from my dad. He started a restaurant about 35 years ago.
My grandmother taught me how to make jerk chicken, as well as my mom and my aunt. Those are like the three main chefs in our family.
I trust your grandma.
They all have their unique perspective, and I kind of took all of
unique? Whoa. This ain't like making damn freaking casserole. All the ingredients is the same. You know what, Ori? Don't be too judgmental. I love judgmental because I like jerk chicken and I like food. As you can see, I like food. So I'm gonna take this a little person when I hear some bullshit, I know better. You know what? Listen. People in Jamaica, don't worry, I get you. They ain't know about the zinc. Put the zinc in the bucket, let... I didn't say nothing. The pit...
perspective and put my own unique twist on it.
My dad, oh, Lord.
And then come home. And by the way, working two jobs is very, very Jamaican. If you're Jamaican, you know. Mm. Two or three is the bare minimum for any Jamaican. So he'll come home from working two jobs, then cook dinner for a family of five. And he'll make the oxtail, the curry chicken, curry goat, everything.
Jerk chicken is bold, spicy, a little bit sweet. It surprises you in the best way. It's like when you're having a crazy day, like I have to have some jerk chicken. Like it just makes everything okay in the world again.
what's going to make jerk chicken authentic is going to be your sauce. I feel like that's the foundation. Your marinade, it's got to be right. And the sauce that you pour on top after it's done cooking, it's got to put the icing on the cake. Okay. I think they're going to like it. The flavor's going to be right. People have been loving it for 30 plus years.
Okay. I like it. They did wings. I personally love a little tip, but, you know, it's not here.
Now, they use wings. That's another red flag. You use the thigh. It's the thigh. It's the leg quarters. You know what I mean? But I ain't saying nothing, you know. It's still cool. It can still work. But you know, you use what you get. You probably just have to use what you got.
Okay. It do smell a little barbecue-y, which is concerning. Because then it smells like grilled barbecue. It smells like barbecue sauce a little bit.
And it gave me a little sauce. It's a little bit salty.
That just pissed me off how she eat that just now. I don't know why. I'm sorry. That just pissed me off.
For my palate, but it's very good.
It's hot. But they're not touching me.
I love how the color.
I noticed they only taste the worst. So
we're always looking for these like kind of dark parts. That's like the searing, that's the grilling. That's what you're always looking for in an authentic jerk chicken.
If I went to my house and I'm making jerk chicken and I had this, I'm like, ah, it's cool. Like, you feel me? I'll eat this like on a Tuesday, something like that.
I feel like for this one, although I think it is good and it is authentic, I'm getting lost in the salt. I would honestly probably give this a 6 just because it's a little bit too salty for me, but I would totally order this. I'd probably have it with some rice and peas, maybe cut some of that salt out, but I think overall it's pretty good.
No, it's nice though. A little salty though.
Okay, I
guess. A little on the salty side.
I believe it's salty for
real. This one's salt. I want more flavor. You need some herbs. I really give it like a 7. It's good.
I am going to win because my jerk chicken is a lifestyle choice. When you bite into it, it's going to be juicy, it's going to be moist, and then it's going to give you that heat that you want right at the end.
What the hell is some lifestyle? What the hell? Why so? That look wrong.
It looks like fancy jerk chicken to me.
So this one got the smell. Respect me.
Yeah, I see the they got like the little flakes and you know the plating is nice. You know what I mean? But you get points for that too. It's nice.
I knew this wasn't it based off the pepper flakes that was on top. You don't use that for this. They saw this on YouTube. They saw a quick Jamaican how can you make jerk chicken in 30 minutes. It's not it. Nah.
Spice is like the first thing that hits you. I'm not too big of a fan of like super wet jerk chicken. So it's a little,
I like my own little dry too, man. Yeah.
Not too bad. It looks a little more like a Asian Zen type way versus a.
See? That's what I'm saying. It's too shiny.
That's not it. This is like a party favorite. It's not jerk chicken. This is like me doing Super Bowl or something like that.
I'm tell
like,
you.
Bring this. But this is not real jerk chicken. This is like.
She didn't even jerk chicken. She called it a lifestyle chicken.
Respectfully. I gotta say respectfully. Just so people know. I mean, ain't no beef.
No, no, no respect for nothing.
Sauce to it.
It's all the chicken.
When I eat it, I feel like I'm eating the marinade. I'm going to give this a 6 just because the flavor wasn't really there for me.
I wouldn't call it a jerk chicken. When I think of jerk chicken, it comes with a certain flavor. It comes with a certain aesthetic. It's not supposed to be saucy. I hate saucy jerk chicken because that just means that you cooked it and it went like this. And then probably put it in the oven back in for like another 10 minutes so it looked like it cooked the whole time. I ain't low. I know what y'all be doing. On a jerk chicken scale, this is a 2 out of 10.
I can respect that. Because the look of it was too shiny. It's too shiny.
So it makes my jerk
chicken. Mike, let me see. You talk all this shit. Let's see.
I make it on the grill.
Ah, okay. Mike win. Because when he was talking about he put it in the oven, I was like, okay, the oven, I wanted to hear him win. I hear what he said. I'm glad. Listen, Mike win.
It's made and it's not on the grill, then it's not real jerk chicken. Period.
Oh, Mike went. Okay, I see why Mike talks all this shit. I see why. Mike used the leg quarters. I think that's what it is. The leg, the proper wings, but he ain't cut it up, but I ain't gonna say nothing. But he used the right leg, I mean the right meat, or whatever, the right portion of the leg, and he put it on the grill. He went.
Just
If they ain't ready, they hate me.
Alright, here we go. Okay, so we got a little bit of dark meat here. We're already kind of starting
to get
some good color.
That is burnt.
I see a little bit of charring on the back. I am personally don't even care for that.
Right. I might have to take back you in. Mike, the back of that chicken look like one car tire. That bitch black, Mike. What the hell are you doing? Literally, you get distracted while making the chicken.
That much? Because it's like, it's bordering on burned?
So this is a little bit what I was referring to as far as like the wet versus, you know, you can tell the difference between the last one and this one.
As I'm trying to pull it off, it's not like falling off of the bone, which can cause a little bit of an issue.
It's pretty good. I'm not gonna lie.
I'm having a hard time chewing it. Sorry, guys.
It's a little bit overdone to me.
It's got the texture right. It's not wet at all. It's got like a crisp to it on the skin. You probably put it on the grill the way it's cooked.
Traditionally, jerk chicken is served dry, but I just think that a beautiful sauce is nice to complement that.
Stop messing up people's
stuff. Also not giving me the heat that I'm looking for. Like, I really want it to be hot, and I'm tasting...
But everybody don't like their jerk chicken like that. Everybody don't want it to be...
It looked like jerk chicken. Bit into it. I got a little crisp. Just the flavor wasn't as strong as I would typically like it, but...
Okay, my answer.
They did a good job, for sure. I'll probably give this one, like, an 8.
Whew!
Watch out.
On a scale of 1 to 10, it would probably have to be a 2. Sorry.
Still get more than your damn terrible chicken. What?
Since that I won, you know what I mean? I got the 30 years of knowledge worked into my sauce, you know what I mean, that I developed and made my own. So shout out to my mom and my dad, you feel me? Shout out to Natural Light Jamaican Restaurant. That's basically
the
foundation.
Let me tell you what happened, right? Mike couldn't win. Mike just needed to let his chicken marinate more or use more spice. I feel like he needed more seasoning herbs. But I didn't taste it. I just tell from what they're saying. And he leave it on the grill too long. That's one. So like he just put it on the grill and walk away. Nah, Mike. You're supposed to watch that bit. Watch that bit. You know what I mean? And as for that jerk teriyaki chicken that y'all make, I know what the hell she was doing. I like to keep... What she call it? She call it lifestyle chicken. It's some lifestyle. What the hell? Hey, yo, if the people say it made like this, leave it like this. Don't put your teriyaki sauce or I like mine with a little twist. Your pepper flakes on the people on chicken. If the Jamaicans say this a done so, if a done so, leave it like how you mean. Oh Lord, stop for this. Leave it like how you mean it. You don't see people. You need to get cussed out. Let me see somebody go on this, under this. I'm posting cussed out for doing shit. Hold on. I'm calling it right now. The chicken with the braids. The chick with the braids is one of the. See? Look. I'm calling it right now. The chick with the braids is the one who tastes like American food. I'm telling you. Like, it was given. Talking about cheaper is a lifestyle. Man, you know. Get off my screen. You wait. Anyhow, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys are new to the channel, man, smash the like button, subscribe, comment down below. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers. Help your boy get there. With that being said, I hope you guys have an amazing day. Be happy, be blessed, and remember, the world is yours. Peace. I'm out.